A very good Sunday morning to all of you, dear parents and audience, and a warm welcome to our second edition of Under the Oak Tree series, a forum for parents addressing topics that matter to them. I am Mahalakshmi, the pre-primary coordinator of Sarjapur Road, Silver Oaks, Bangalore. Today, we have with us someone who's passionate about her actions and their impact on the environment. I have the pleasure of introducing Ms. Lakshmi Prabha, mother of Adi Seshan, a student at this Whitefield campus. Through her initiatives, Pranapurna and Rent a Cutlery, she has shown truly that change begins with me and that nothing is impossible. A very warm welcome to you, ma'am, from the Silver Oaks family. It's my pleasure and privilege. Thank you, ma'am. It's my pleasure and privilege to meet you, as sustainability is something very close to my heart too. I'm sure we will take back many things with us today. Dear audience, since this is a live webcast, request you to post your questions in the chat window and they will be addressed during the question answer session. All of us are eager to hear from you, ma'am. Shall we get started?
Sure, Mahamam. I thank Silver Oak School for giving me this opportunity for inspiring the wave of awareness to all of us.
Thank you. An engineer by profession, but an eco-warrior now. It'll be great to hear about your journey of transformation.
Sure, ma'am. My journey of transformation started in 2012, about 8 years ago, when I watched a TV show called Satyameva Jayate, and where I saw the show wherein they were showing how the waste from each home, my home, is creating a landfill, a mounting landfill outside the city in a beautiful village, and how that is contaminating our water, soil, and air. That was an eye-opener for me, and I started seeking that what should I do for the problem that is existing around me. So I started segregating my waste into three types at my home level, into wet waste or kitchen waste, dry waste, and sanitary waste. And with this, I got a realization that, I started also to compost our wet waste, by which the food waste in our house also started reducing. I also started seeing that as a family, how much plastics we were generating with the dry waste we were segregating. So our seek started to see where are the places where we can get package-free foods. So the whole idea and humble realization that we got is, what we seek, we get. So this is our personal experience. And once we started seeing, that gave us opened doors of switching from a chemical-laden food or a pesticide-laden food to a chemical-free food. One fine day, about 5 years ago, I realized that, there were 1,000 chemicals around me in what I use and what I put, like a cosmetics, floor cleaner, toilet cleaners, were contributing a lot of wellness hindrance to me and my family. The immunity system is getting damaged because of the chemical interruptions to me as well as to the environment. So the Varthur Lake, Belandur Lake issues of burning and foaming made me realize that what I use in my home is causing the problem around me. So now I'm very happy to say that 99.9% of my house is chemical free.
Wow, that's wonderful, ma'am. It's a great achievement. Sustainability is a very big word and means many things to many people. Most of us think that it's the duty of the government or big organizations. How and what does it mean to us? And what do you think each one of us can do at an individual level?
Sure, ma'am. As you rightly said, sustainability means for each one different things. There is a saying, by a Tibetan saint called Lao Tzu. And it goes like this. A journey of 1,000 steps starts with a single step. And every droplet contributes to the mighty ocean. Sustainability, in very simple terms, and this is my very, very humble realization, that anything that doesn't burden your soil, water and air is sustainability. The contribution can be anything. Even a tiny microorganism is beneficial for us. Even the biggest, mammal or tree or mountain is beneficial in its own way. So every contribution counts.
Ma'am, it's wonderful listening to you, to your inspiring story. And I can connect so well because sustainability is also something very close to me. As I said earlier, I also practice composting my kitchen waste. I make the bioenzyme and I use this for my kitchen garden, my terrace garden. I also avoid using single plastic in any form. It is so wonderful to hear from you. Ma'am, we have a young accounts from all our four schools who are eco-warriors in their own right. And they are doing their bit towards planet Earth. They are here to share their thoughts with you.
I'm lovely and waiting to see them.
Good morning, ma'am. My name is Shreya Shekhar. I'm from Silver Oaks International School, Bangalore, Sarjapuram.
Good morning, ma'am. I am Meghna from Grade 10, Silver Oaks, Hyderabad.
Hi, ma'am. I'm Manish Sai Rayala, studying 5th grade in Silver Oaks International School, Whitefield.
I am Sai Karthik from Grade 5, studying Silver Oaks International School, Visakhapatnam.
Ms. Lakshmi, these children have done their homework and they've prepared a list of chemicals in the products of everyday use. And I'm sure they're waiting to share it with you.
Sure.
Okay, ma'am. So I looked at the chemical ingredients in toothpaste. So the chemical ingredients are sulfate, sodium fluoride, and sodium lauryl.
Well, ma'am, I have taken into the cosmetic industry and some of the harmful chemicals that I have looked into are methyl parabens, SLES, retinyl palmitate, and polyparabens.
So, ma'am, I looked at the chemicals of floor cleaner, and the chemicals are sodium bicarbonate, benzyl conium chloride, cocamidopropyl betaine, lauryl alkyl ethoxylate. These chemicals have side effects such as muscle spasm, hives, fever, eye irritation, and skin disorders.
Wow, he's already done his homework and found out the effects of these chemicals on us.
I'd like to share ingredients of a toilet cleaner that are sodium hypochlorite, sodium lauryl, lauryl amine oxide, sodium hydroxide, perfume, and water.
Ma'am, our children may be young, but they're wise beyond their years. You know what Karthik has done? He has developed an app on sustainability, Share to Care, on the principles of the three R's, reduce, reuse, and recycle. We will be sharing it with the parents in our Facebook page.
Wonderful, wonderful, Karthik.
Ma'am, could you tell us what are the effects of these chemicals in our day-to-day life items?
Sure, Shreya and everybody. There are three ways mainly in which toxins enter our body and to the environment around us. One is inhalation, second is ingestion, and third is skin contact. Our skin is the largest porous organ in our body, and we have pores from top of our head till the bottom of our feet. And that is why whichever items we put on ourselves, say for example, if it's an oil or anything like cosmetic or anything, it actually directly enters the body, the system, and it will have its own effects on us. That is like, for example, all these chemicals that you guys have read, I'm very glad that we have read. I'll give you an example. We should be aware, the whole point to note here that you people have wonderfully done is, we all should be aware of what we are putting on us. You know, when we go to a grocery store, if we take a biscuit packet or if we take any food item, do we read the ingredients available on the packet or not? Do we do it?
Yes, ma'am.
So we do it. The same thing we would like, we would, if we could practice with the things that we use around us, the floor cleaner, the toilet cleaner, the cosmetics, you know, the talcum powder, everything that you're using on you, it will, you know, that starts our step of change. Okay. And these chemicals, whatever is in various components, not only in our food, but also in what we are putting on us and around us. It causes various kinds of problems like your lung issues, there are a lot of allergy issues, and there are also pesticide traces in many items that we use, which can cause long-term nerve damages and carcinogenic effect. So this thing has to be addressed. So how can we really do is something, we need to think about. And not only that, we are putting on ourselves. From us, it goes into the water through the sewage, into our water bodies and the soil, thus enhancing the chemical print around us. And what grows on the soil and the water comes back to us. This is the circle of life. What we sow, so we reap. Like what we, throw comes back to us in some form or the other.
Ma'am, it's so frightening when we hear you and what the chemicals do to us. I'm sure many of us in the audience also have received a rude jolt, and started thinking about the consequence of using these on an everyday basis.
Ma'am, thank you for enlightening and describing some of the problematic chemicals that we use in our daily routine. But we all know that every problem has a solution. So can you please throw some light on the solution for these problems?
Definitely, Meghna and Maha Ma'am. This is not to frighten any people, but it is a very, very humble awareness and realization that what we as a family came to know, and when we started using natural alternatives, there is always complex problems have very simple solutions. And the simple solution for this complex issue around us is in our own hands. The solution is not anywhere else. The solution is in our hands. Like for example, climate change is a very big buzzword that is amongst the world, among children and everybody, it is going on. Climate change is not only cutting trees, but it's also cutting trees. Climate change is also caused because of me and you. With what we use, the chemicals we use, the chemicals we consume, and the chemicals that goes out from our body system and into the water, So the natural alternatives that we can go for are natural cleaners made out of citrus peels and our traditional methods of soap nets. If you can all see, this is soap net in English, arita in Hindi, and kungudukai in Telugu, and antuvalakai in Kannada. Okay, soap nets, these are all our native trees. It's a berry from the native tree which is used for all cleaning purposes. And it has antibacterial and natural, cleaning properties. So this is shikekai. If you had seen, you'll be going down the memory lane, some of you, in grandmother times or in, in your villages, you would have seen this. This is the thorny creeper bush, actually. It is used for, especially for hair shampooing and for dishwashing. So the main alternative is, the switch to a chemical-free living is using a simple, natural, citrus peel chemical-free cleaner along with whatever ingredients I showed you, soap nuts, shikakai, and of course, the humble wood ash. Now, how these can replace all the chemicals around you, okay? How can we do about it is something we will be seeing in the next section, yeah.
Ma'am, I think you can share the recipe of the bioenzyme with them.
Sure, I'm going to do that. So all you need to do the simple citrus peel bioenzyme is take about 300 grams of citrus peels. It can be pineapple peel, Mosambi peel, lemon peel or orange peel. Take about 100 grams of your brown jaggery. And take about 1 liter of water. Put this in a container, in a plastic container with an airtight lid. And mix all these ingredients in and keep it in a cool, dark place. This process of fermentation will take about 3 months. The process goes like this. And all this will be shared to the parents by the school team. And Keep it in an airtight, cool, dark place, a lid, and stir the contents and keep it aside. Do this for first 2 weeks. And after that, occasionally open the lid, stir the contents and keep it aside. Initially, the peels will be floating. Once at the end of third month, this process takes 3 months. At the end of third month, all the peels will completely go down. You're submerged. That is when your natural citrus peel cleaner liquid is ready. And this liquid, you know, has to be strained. And this is how it looks. You know, it is a very beautiful natural cleaner made out of biodegradable substances. So the simple point to make is, to note is, what is digestible to me is what I put on my body, correct? So if I put something which is not digestible, definitely my body throws up or reacts. Similarly, for the environment, if we put something which is digestible, the earth can digest, the water, soil can digest. If something is put which is not digestible, definitely the water bodies throw up, the soil shows up, and you know it kills. That is when we have all the, when the balance, immunity of the system is, you know, damaged, is when the problems around us increase. Okay, so how to use this chemical? Lakshmi ma'am is telling that just this is like a juice. Trust me, it smells very divine, very pleasant. And how can we really use this? This is a simple floor cleaner which can replace all your chemicals. And the important point to note is the water consumed by using natural cleaners is very less. Okay, because natural lather comes or no lather comes, which in turn will avoid or reduce the water usage. Water is a commodity and it's a right to every living thing in this world. Whether it is the tiniest microorganism or the biggest, you know, mountains or the trees, everything needs water. And if only us, you know, deplete the water resources by, you know, creating so many single-use disposables, or by, you know, using a lot of chemicals to wash off lot and waste water, this water resources for our future generations definitely depletes. So this simple liquid can be used as a floor cleaner. This can be used like a toilet cleaner. This can also be used as a laundry detergent for your clothes, but in combination with soap nuts. It can be used as a dishwashing liquid and your chimney cleaner also along with soap nuts. And you can also use soap nuts as your shampoo. Just take a handful of soap nuts in a cup of water, soak it overnight, and next day squash the liquid. Your shampoo is ready. Use it along with little shikakai powder and albizia powder. You know, you would have heard of it. That's a green powder, which is a natural conditioner. So, and of course, we also have wood ash, which is a dishwashing powder. You may ask, where do we get wood ash now? If you have a source nearby where they make firewood pizzas, or a tandoor, you know, a place where they make tandoor items, they will be using charcoal and they will be using firewood pizza. This will be, or from a local brick kiln, okay, where they'll be using old firewood to burn as a fuel, okay. Here you can get the wood ash and then you can mix it with soap nut powder, and this is your dishwashing powder. It is so simple, but it's not cumbersome. It may sound very cumbersome. Trust me, the process once you start will be very simple. But the point to note here is, you know, in this fast times, can we really, you know, do all these things or not? Definitely you can do. We are going to talk about it.
Ma'am, something very interesting that I remembered when listening to you. You know how we started doing enzymes at school? So once the children had oranges for their snacks. And when I went into the dining hall, I saw a huge pile of orange peel. And I felt, oh God, I hope they are not going to throw this. So I asked them to keep it inside the fridge. And then later we got, you know, the next day, the jaggery powder. And the children made it themselves. I told them, because it's a very simple recipe for you to remember. It is 1:3:10. So 1 part of jaggery, 3 parts of the citrus peel, and 10 parts of water. So, and the funniest part, or I mean the amazing part, was children from pre-primary, the youngest acorns, till the oldest, the 10th graders, they all made the enzyme and they kept stirring it, opening the lid. You know, it was a process, and they used to go and see what's happening to it. Is it settling down? And then we were able to use it, you know, for cleaning purposes inside the school. So I felt I should share this with you.
Definitely.
As you say, it is difficult when you start. But then but once you start doing it, I think, as you said, because I have heard many of my colleagues, you know, teachers around, they say, ma'am, we are inspired by you, so we want to do it. And they've started using it also. So I think that is very important. And once children know why it is important to start doing it, I'm sure they'll start practicing it too. So,
yeah, I agree with you.
Dear parents, we'll be sharing the ingredients and recipes for making your own cosmetics, tooth powder, and paper dustbin liners on our Facebook page. Sometimes I feel, maybe some people feel newspaper should not be wasted. But when I started seeing the, you know, plastic dustbin liners inside the dustbins, I felt, no, we are doing something wrong. Let's change it. So we started teaching the maids in our school also how to make the dustbin liner. It's very simple. You don't need a pair of scissors, or you don't need gum. So children were able to fold it. Even the youngest ones were able to do it in their own ways. And they've started using it, and they've started pointing out that, ma'am, there's a plastic, you know, cover here. It should not be there. You know, so that was very nice. I was happy that our young children could, you know, understand the importance of not using plastic. We've seen it around. We've seen our pre-primary children also calling themselves eco warriors and going around and cleaning and seeing if they see a tiny piece of plastic also, they say, ma'am, this will get into, you know, a bird, or it'll go into the mouth, I mean, the stomach of a fish, you know. So I think we have to start when they are young. And then I think we will need not worry about the future. I'm sure they will take it forward.
Yes, ma'am, that was very nice, you know, to know about how Silver Oaks has taken the initiative. And I also heard that, you know, only reusable cutlery is used in the school. And I'm really proud to know about it.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm sure our audience is eagerly waiting for answers to their questions. Over to you, Meghna and Shreya.
I just have one point which I missed. Excuse me, Meghna. There is always a question, like, you know, when we do a session like this and people get inspired, they also start making their own enzymes. But as the point, a period of time goes, you know, that they somewhere due to their busy lives and so many things, the continuity of this particular concept is somewhere stopped. So when we have, we can do to continually, you know, use or do the shift from the chemical laden living to the chemical free living is one is the DIY is the best, where it imprint into my house. That is my realization. The plastic imprint into my house. There are minimum 20 chemical cleaners that we were using in our house. So if you multiply that by 12 per month, by 20 boxes in the form of bottles and so many things. By the end of 1 year, 12 months, only my house was generating 240 plastic boxes. If we quantify this to the world population, imagine the plastic imprint into each and every house. Now, this point was one push for me to start the natural chemical cleaners. But the second point is with the general, many of my friends couldn't continue at a point of time. So what is our experience in this last 5 years of starting our initiative called Pranapuna Collective is, if you're not able to make your DIY, do it yourself, please support local ventures, social impact ventures, who are, you know, supplying these biodegradable alternatives of natural cleaners, and by which we are also supporting a whole lot of livelihoods. And, you know, I would like to add, ma'am, I'm sorry.
Thank you for that, ma'am.
Yeah.
There was one more thing I felt that many people would want to know. I think many of us have at least, I mean, a few pots in our balcony or terrace or whatever. So I'm sure people know that using pesticides or, you know, something for insecticides on them is harmful. So what can they do? So I think, see, I do something which is very simple. It's called 3G. So again, you know, it's a ratio here. Math comes in again. So you have equal quantities of ginger, garlic, and green chili. That's how you get the name 3G. You grind it, you could store it in the refrigerator too. And 1:10, I think same applies to the bioenzyme also. For most things, you know, dilute 1:10, right? So here also 1:10, they dilute it, filter the residue, and then they spray it on the plants. And always remember, spraying anything on plants should be done early in the morning or late in the evening. It should not be done during this when the sunlight is there. You know, the harshness might, scotch the leaves. Okay. So this is a very simple recipe that everyone can follow. You also, I'm sure most of them who love plants would have read that neem oil is a very good, pesticide. But neem oil, you do have to add a little bit of a detergent. So again, when you look at not using detergents, I'm sure your Rita nut or your soap nut, you know, your shika kai would come in useful, right? It will cause that lather.
Absolutely.
It will make the oil mix with the water, and you give it a good shake, dilute it again, and then spray it on your plants. I think that is something which many of us don't know. And I think we should start using such things. And I'm very happy. I don't know, whenever I talk, I do get connected back to our children. So they have gone home and told their parents also this, that we should not use pesticides. And, you know, ma'am has taught us 3G and we want to, you know, do it. So I've heard from parents who have shared, you know, their stories of what the children come back and tell them.
Hello. Well, ma'am, one of the questions we've got from the parents is that we would like to know how to avoid plastic in our life. And also we would like to know how to segregate waste and reuse it.
Okay, this is a very close to my heart topic, because that is a whole realization and everything is connected. So very simple things that I practice in life, I would like to share with you. Whenever you go outside, please carry your own steel water bottle, you know, so that you can avoid any kind of bottled water. You know, whether you go to a local inside the city or outside the city, anywhere. Even when we go on a long travel, we carry 4 of our water bottles. And whenever we leave the hotel, we boil the water, cool it, and put it in our bottles and go. So we avoid single-use plastic water bottle. Second is always have your own bags. You know, have your own bags, carry bags in your car or, you know, in your handbag, so that if at all suddenly you want to buy something, you need to generate that single-use cover. You know, whether it is a plastic cover or even if it's a cloth bag, any new thing is a big no-no. Because everything needs energy and resources to make. And we, as a conscious consumer, because we have to be the change, to see the change in the world. I very humbly believe, because as Mahatma Gandhiji says, be the change you want to see in the world. And I really practice this in my life. And it is worked. That is when we can see the sea of change around us. If we don't do it, but expect the world. So, and then one more thing, in any of your parties, events or functions, or even when you're going outside, if you can carry your own, I know this is going to be a little more, difficult, but if you can carry your own spoon, a small tumbler and a small plate, you can still enjoy. See, activism or being conscious is not leaving out enjoyment. Enjoy your life. Live every moment, you know, but do it consciously so that we leave a beautiful place for ourselves and the world. So these are the ways in which in any parties or functions that you are going to have in your family, avoid any single-use disposables, whether it is biodegradable or plastic or thermocol, and use only reusable cutlery, like your steel cutlery. Use, wash, rinse, and reuse. Reduce, reuse is the way to go. And of course, yeah, segregation of waste, someone had asked. Very simple step you can take. I don't know which part of Bangalore or are you staying anywhere outside Bangalore? I'm not sure. But all over India, we have this law in place that every household have to segregate their waste into three types, which is the wet waste or kitchen waste. Why we have to segregate waste is anything that comes from the earth, you know, has to go back to the earth. That is the whole idea. Because your food waste, it has to be composted, okay? Or it is converted into a biogas. Second is your plastic waste. Ideally, whatever is recyclable goes to a recycling unit and gets recycled. Third is your sanitary waste, which is, you know, goes through an authorized biomedical vendor who has to pick it up and takes it to the incinerator. So each has its own properties and all these cannot be mixed. If it is mixed, it cannot be fixed. That is a simple, humble mantra. If it is mixed and put in the landfill, it will create the, you know, greenhouse gases, methane and other harmful gases. Definitely this will, when you quantify it, only your house waste, when you put, will not affect. But when everybody's, you know, collects, the amount of gases released will be very high. And this definitely contributes to heating our atmosphere and directly affects the climate change. So start simple, segregate your waste. If at all your municipality is not picking the segregated waste, please do try to compost your waste, which is very, very simple. All these, whoever would like to take guidance from me, please do mail me. The school will be sharing my email ID. I'll be very glad to guide you with resources where you can look up and implement in your life.
Thank you, ma'am.
Well, ma'am, another question we've got. Can you tell us how to avoid red ants and black ants eating away our plants without spraying chemicals on them?
The simplest and the very easiest solution is in our kitchen. Turmeric powder actually helps in repelling ants. And that's why we used to put in our houses, bordering our houses with little salt and turmeric. If you remember, if you ask your mother or your grandmother, they'll be telling. Nowadays, we are using chemicals or pesticides to completely avoid any kind of living things or pests around us. So the simple things to repel is good for us because and good for the other beings. Yeah, to answer your question, please try putting turmeric powder on around the pots.
Ma'am, so we have another question. And the question is, how can we spread awareness to people on not using non-biodegradable items?
As I, as I shared, the change begins with you. Once the change begins with you, it just inspires everybody around you. So, you know, the change begins with you and that just carries on like a ripple effect.
Ma'am, another question is, if we use wood ash, will it clog our sinks?
It will not. If it's a fine powder, it doesn't. But if your pipe is too twisted, you know, it depends from apartments to apartments, how the piping is also done, or houses to houses. I've been using wood ash in my house for the last 3 to 4 years. And I have not seen this problem of clogging the sink. It's likewise the same with my other members who are using the wood ash.
Ma'am, so another question we've got is that what is sustainable development?
Yes. Sustainable development is, you know, The country's economy definitely depends on the health of the people, on the employment that is created for a country's citizens. Socio-economic and development sustainable goals, all three have to go together, so that they eliminate the issues of poverty, climate change, and everything. So when a country is sustainable, it's like a country's immune system is strong. When the immune system is strong, any external influence or any kind of external influence will not affect the country's health. That is why the sustainable development goals have been signed by designated by UN, and there are members who have signed the SDGs, and in fact India has also signed the SDGs.
So, ma'am, there's another question. Can you please share any easy process for homemade manure from kitchen waste?
Sure. So, for making kitchen waste, I would request you to first start collecting your peels separately, your vegetable and fruit peels. Take a small earthen pot or take an old bucket and you can drill holes. Have a lid for it. Get some, microbial cocopeat. There are various online sites which have the microbial cocopeat, or simplest would be your garden cocopeat that you get from any nursery around you. Take the bucket, add about 4 inches of your cocopeat to the bottom layer, and add some crushed dry leaves from your garden or from your apartment community or villa community if you have. Otherwise, cocopeat is enough. Collect your everyday kitchen waste. Do you know 65% of a house waste generated in a daily basis is only kitchen waste? Imagine if we are able to handle this waste, what a huge contribution we are going to do to our environment, because we are not going to send our kitchen waste outside the house, thereby avoiding carbon emissions due to transport of our waste to just dump it elsewhere. Put the cocopeat, take a handful of your vegetable or fruit peels, add it on the cocopeat, cover it back with your cocopeat. This is an everyday process to initiate the microbial activity. Add about 2 tablespoons of buttermilk to this process, to this lot. And every week, once or twice, you can add the buttermilk. When the bucket is full, you do this process daily. Keep the bucket closed and leave it aside in a place where there is no rain falling under a roof. Okay, but enough sunlight should be there, or it should be airy. After 3 weeks or 4 weeks, you could see that like a magic, all your peels have disintegrated into beautiful soil and compost. This is an excellent manure with its own nutrients and minerals, and it can be used in your own garden. This will help in improving the immunity of the plants. That is when the plant's immunity grows, the pest attack reduces.
Ma'am, our eco warrior Manish has a question for you.
Sure.
Okay, so ma'am, how does environment sustainability have impact on country's economy?
Definitely, Manish, it's a wonderful question you have asked. I'm so happy, I'm getting to hear you are the future. Kids are the future eyes of our country. Okay. If the sustainable initiatives are there, wherein we contribute positively to our wellness of the people. When you say sustainability, you are contributing. Why do we use natural cleaners? Why are we avoiding chemicals? For the whole lot of health benefit for all of us, right? And for the environment, correct? So when we are going to switch to natural alternatives, eat pesticide-free food, the wellness of the people improves. When wellness of the citizens improves, naturally the country's economy grows, because there will be more people will be more healthy to work. And second thing is, the environmental sustainability generates more employment also within a country. So we will not be depleting much of our natural resources. You know, we cannot keep on depleting any petrochemical items like plastic and other things. If you see, we cannot keep on depleting the resources from the earth. You know, at one fine stage, it will be run out of the resources. So when a country runs out of resources due to overuse, naturally it will try to import from other countries where it is used. Rather, if we are going to manage within our own country, you know, becoming self-reliant, then the need for importing, which involves its own high costs, all that will be avoided or it will be reduced. So in this way, we are also contributing to a better economy of our own country and lot of employment generated. I hope I answered your question, Manish. I hope you understood.
Ma'am, we have another question from the parents. Is there any organic toothpaste readily available in the supermarket?
Yes, sir. So we'll be sharing DIY tooth powder recipe in our by the school and DIY, do it yourself, skin cream, which is very easy and simple to make and devoid of any parabens or SLES, etc., which causes huge damage to our skin and health. And there are, you know, local initiatives, social impact ventures in the market, which are producing, natural alternatives to various things. Please do, it'd be nice if we can support them and, you know, so that, you know, be vocal for local, which will really help in wellness of all of us and the environment.
Well, ma'am, we have another question from the parents. The question was, how do consumers recognize organic and non-organic products in the market? Will there be any symbol or logo of any sort printed on the product?
Yes, it's a very good question. This is the trigger, or this is the, you know, that light that we all, I'm happy that this question came. One thing is by going and reading the ingredients, as our children here did the activity, wonderful thing. So first, let us be aware of what we are consuming. That is the first step. Second thing is, you have some logos like biodegradable or, you know, cruelty free or, you know, organic. There are some, mostly one of these will be available on the products that you use, or biodegradable. These are all some of the things you need to look for. You know, chemical free, toxin free, this will be there. So this is how you recognize. And second main thing is the source. Once you have started the seek, automatically doors will open where you will start knowing about various initiatives who are actually supplying. So now when you know about floor cleaner or something, you'll start going and searching for, are there any, one is DIY, you can directly, but if it is not possible, you can go ahead and search, and you have a lot of initiatives who have come up with this.
Ma'am, another question is, what can be the alternatives for chemical soaps?
Yes, chemical soap, chemical soap has a lot of harmful ingredients that can cause long-term allergies, and the artificial perfumes and scents in various things directly affects our lung system and all. The alternative, best alternative would be your humble back to basics basin powder or the green moong powder. Generally, to keep your skin conditioned, ideally before every bath or after every bath, pure cold pressed coconut oil, which is an antimicrobial and anti-fungicidal ingredient, has to be applied. The oil has to be applied on our skin before or after the bath. But the best way is to use your natural powders, like your basin powder, along with curd or milk. But I would suggest you can use the green moong powder, which also has that moisturizing effect on your skin, of course with the coconut oil. Even handmade soaps can be just one step better than your chemical soap. They also contain artificial scents. Just be aware of what you are consuming. They can contain synthetic flavors, synthetic fragrances, and caustic soda, which is called lye, L-Y-E, which is also not good for the water bodies.
Ma'am, thank you, ma'am. One last question from the parents was that, can in this COVID period, can you give us a natural hand sanitizer, a recipe for a natural hand sanitizer?
So hand sanitizer, we don't really have naturally, but you can make your own natural hand wash, which will not burn your skin, basically. So how you can do is, as I told you, you can take a bottle, 1 liter bottle. You can fill about 400 grams of soap nuts, Rita, that I showed you, 400 grams. And the rest of the bottle, you can fill it with the citrus peel, the natural cleaner that we did, which we showed it as a DIY. Leave it aside for 5 days, open the lid, close the lid, keep it in a cool, dark place. At the end of 5th day, you can just squash the contents, dilute it in a bottle, and keep it in a strain it in a bottle. Add some essential oils, which is pure, not synthetic, but pure. Dilute it 1:10, and use it for washing your hands. This can be a natural way in your house to wash your hands.
Well, thank you, ma'am. I just have one question. Like, as a student who's studying in grade 10 right now, we have encountered SDGs, that is Sustainable Development Goals, multiple times. So my question is that right now, at the moment, currently, where is India standing with proposing and actually making sure that the SDGs are being followed in the country?
It's a very good question. Elaborately, I would like to, honestly telling, I would like to come back with you with a more elaborate answer, definitely. But what I understand and see, we have definitely a long way to go, but there is a lot of positive things that is happening around us, wherein there are more, since I am myself running a social impact venture called Pranapurna Collective, because it's a whole passion-based venture. We are seeing that there are a lot of initiators like this who are actually, catering to the SDGs. For example, our own collective is catering to 6 UN sustainability goals of, climate change, climate action, sustainable cities and communities, industry innovation, and various things, the response. Responsible consumerism, circular economy, social inclusivity, all these things. So elaborately, I would definitely answer your question after this session, Meghna.
Sure, ma'am. We had another question from the parents. The question was, why is sustainability usually looked as fanaticism?
I agree with that. I agree in the sense, as I said, sustainability is a big word, as we discussed. There is fanaticism seen across the public, but my experience, I can talk from my experience, because I see myself as an activist about 4 years ago, but I realized that, I enjoy the process. That's when I totally toned down, because every droplet counts. Now I have stopped complaining, saying that he doesn't do, they don't do, nothing. Whatever everyone does, see, I may be contributing in my own ways. For example, I don't use any single-use disposables. I don't use any chemicals. But there are some of my friends who use public transport. They avoid their own vehicles, going. I know some of the kids who plant trees. There I know some of groups who plant trees across, increasing green cover. So every small droplet counts. There is nothing big or nothing small. Yes, it'll be nice, but the realization happens individual level, you know, and it will take some time before that can spread. But one humble, my own experience I would share is, if we do something from the heart, we definitely inspire someone somewhere. I hope I answered your question. So if you have more, I would, you know, you can connect to me over email.
That's very true, Lakshmi ma'am. You know, with your inspiration, you can inspire others. Very right. Thank you so much for sparing your time on a Sunday morning. Wishing you all the very best and hope you keep inspiring everyone who you meet to treat the path of zero waste and sustainability. I think we should listen to you another day to hear about your rental cutlery and a little more about Pranapurna, which is, you know, providing livelihood to the transgender community. Dear parents, hope you had an enlightening session today. Join us next week for a talk show with a psychologist who will address problems faced by parents during our stay at home in these testing times. Thank you, Lakshmi ma'am, again. Thank you, dear children, for making this show very interactive and posing your questions. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, audience. Have a great Sunday. See you then. Bye.
Thank you all. Thank you.